Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. You know, I grabbed a pile of things from my bathroom, and I actually used these things to write a poem. I'm going to start today with a poem, but how could all of these things from the bathroom inspire me to write a poem? Well, that poem is actually all about the simple machine science that are found in these items in my bathroom. Now remember, simple machines are anything that makes our work easier. So I'm going to read the first line of the poem, and then we're going to go on a little hunt to see if we can find the thing that the poem is talking about. But we're not just going to see if we can find it, we're going to try that thing out to see if it really does match the clue from the poem. So take a look at what kind of things we have in front of us. So we've zoomed in so you can take a closer look at some of the items. We have a scissors, fingernail clipper, Q-tip, hair beret, tweezers, that's a flossing stick, here's a tub of floss, we have chapstick, hair gel, deodorant, a brush, container for my contacts, a razor, an electric razor, a toothbrush, a tube of toothpaste, some clothespins, this right here is a faucet on my bathroom sink, and we have a roll of toilet paper. So here's the first line of the poem, and it actually has two clues, so here we go. I try a lever that stops the drain and a cap that works because of an inclined plane. Stopping a drain. Well, remember, what do you think? Look around. What's going to stop a drain? Well, I look at this thing and this looks like it fits into a sink. Now, I couldn't bring in my whole bathroom sink, but I could bring in the faucet. And here's a faucet. I'm going to spin the faucet around, and most sinks, you'll be able to see this little thing in the back. When I lift it up, what does it do? Well, this is my sink stopper, and it sits in my sink, and when I pull this lever up, guess what happens? The sink stopper goes down. I think we found the thing that stops a drain. Now, what about, and it's not just a thing, it's a lever that stops the drain. What about a cap that works because of an inclined plane? Well, what's an inclined plane? So now we're onto our cap that works because of an inclined plane. Let's look at some caps and try them out. So I have a cap to some hair gel. How does this cap work? Well, it flips open. And that doesn't look like an inclined plane to me. What about my deodorant? Nope, no inclined plane there. Let's try toothpaste. Here we go. I can't pull it. I have to unscrew it, and what do you know? By trying it out, I think we found our inclined plane. If you look carefully, we're gonna zoom in so you can take a closer look at the cap. Take a look at the top of this tube of toothpaste. I can see an inclined plane that's slanted, but that inclined plane is wrapped around the top of the tube. I found a cap that works because of an inclined plane. Here's the next line of the poem with our next two clues. I try a lever that pinches and grips, and a wedge that separates, cuts, and clips. So let's start with the first one. I try a lever that pinches and grips. What could pinch and grip? Well, I see two things. Do you see them? Let's try it out. Let's try this, and let's try this. What are they? Well, I have a clothespin and I have a tweezers. Let's see if it actually pinches and grips. So here's my lever. You can see it work. And it does pinch and grip. I can use this to hang clothes out on the laundry line, or I could use my tweezers, and this does pinch and grip. I think we found it just by trying it out. Now we're looking for a wedge that separates, cuts, and clips. So what things here do you think we could try that actually cut, clip, and separate? I see a couple of them. Do you see them? I'm thinking a razor, a scissors, and this, a fingernail clipper. So why don't we try them out? Wow, it almost looks like, well, I'll try it out on my fingernail. Line it up, clip it, but think about this. Do we see more than one simple machine at work in this fingernail clipper? I see the wedge up front, but what am I doing here with this part of the fingernail clipper? I think it's a lever. I have a lever and a wedge. Let's look at our scissors. Can I cut and clip with this? I'll try my fingernail again. Or maybe I'll cut a part of my beard. I don't know. Trim it up. think it does cut and clip. And then my razor, we're gonna zoom in so you can take a closer look at the blades on this razor, and you will see that they do cut and clip. We've zoomed in so you can see the blades on this razor, and those blades are actually wedges that separate cut and clip hair that I could shave my face. And now we're ready for the last line of our poem. I try some wheels and axles that spin. What simple machine is a clothespin? All right, here we go. Wheels and axles that spin. Well, I think I see two things that spin. One is obvious. Good old toilet paper. But the other one's not so obvious. I have a container of floss. Now watch what happens when I pull this string. Comes out. So what's going on inside this container of floss? Let's take a closer look by opening it up. We've opened up our container of floss and zoomed in so you can see the wheel and axle in the center, and watch what happens when I pull my string of floss. It spins. I try a wheel and axle that spins. It actually wants to come apart. I might be able to, yep, I can pull it out and you can see this slides over the axle. And it spins. Cool. Isn't it amazing how simple machine science is simply everywhere? Well, we patterned this idea of I Try Science after the book series I Spy. And I Spy book series, all they do is they take just items and objects and spread them out in front of you, and you have to search for certain things that are right there in front of you. They're not even hidden, they're right there. Well, we kind of think that's the same thing about science. The same thing about science is true. Science is right there in front of us, and so often we don't even think about it. But that science is right there in front of us. I try science. Why don't you try it to see if you can find things in your bathroom that are actually simple machines? If you want to learn more about simple machines, check out our links in the video description. Science is so cool, and it's really everywhere. We just have to learn to see it. Thanks for watching.